hard go. Great start from pole position by Jorge Martin. Fabio Quartararo was away superbly as well from the middle of that second row. Quartararo straight up the way from fifth into third place. Not a great start for Pecco Bagnaia. No. He's getting swallowed up. I think Bagnaia is in fifth.
He is. He was getting swallowed up. He almost had Miller going past him into the Doohan corner, but he managed to hold on to it. Miller is in the middle of a real sandwich there into the southern loop.
Bagnaia is on the inside here. We can't see him on the outside of Pecco Bagnaia. It was Fabio Quartararo. That was aggressive by Bagnaia on the inside of Quartararo into the southern loop. Brilliant time to ride on board the left shoulder cam of Bagnaia. Quartararo was out really, really wide. He was almost grass trucking there, wasn't he, going through the Stoner corner. Really got to be
Bagnaia
careful there.
Espargaro there into the Miller corner, so Bagnaia takes Espargaro, and Quartararo looking to take advantage. Espargaro holds on, so huge aggression from a poor start from Bagnaia. He's back where he started in third.
This is as aggressive as we've seen Pecco Bagnaia for much of this 2022 season. How much does he want this MotoGP world title? Well, we've already seen how much he wants it. On the inside of Quartararo into the southern loop, on the inside of Aleix Espargaro with a hard move into the Miller corner. Brilliant by Bagnaia, he's third.
What a start though for the first lap from Jorge Martin. Him and Marc Marquez have pulled a bit of a gap. There's a big move coming from Alex Marquez, trying to force his way past Luca Rini. Jack Miller embroiled in a bit of a battle. He was side by side with his teammate Bagnaia on the approach into Doohan corner, but he's now back down a place. He's back where he started in P8.
Now then, what bother is coming here for Fabio Quartararo, because he's got one of the rapidly quick Ducatis behind him going down this garden straight. Luca Marini might swallow him up here in the slipstream down this 900 metre garden straight. Lap one ticked off. Your race leader is Jorge Martin. Quartararo got great drive.
Espargaro's wide.
Well wide going through the Doohan corner. Is he going to hang on to that fourth place from Quartararo? He is indeed. Quartararo must have got superb drive and corner speed through those two final left-handers. There's Alex Marquez, brilliantness by the younger Marquez sibling. He's on the inside of Marini there through the southern loop.
Contrasting fortunes for Primo Pramac Racing on the first lap. Martin leads the Grand Prix from Marc Marquez, but Joan Zarco's had a shocker, down 12 places to 18th.
Nightmare then for the Frenchman as Fabio Quartararo gets out wide again into that Miller corner. He had a problem there running wide through the Stoner corner on the very first lap. It's been a bit of a scrappy second lap this for Fabio Quartararo. Martin then and Marquez, they're already trying to build up an advantage here early on. At the end of that first lap, Marquez was nearly 8/10 of a second ahead of Bagnaia in third spot. Bagnaia really, really hot going through the Haitian. He was right on those curves. Got to be careful there. They might still be a little bit damp from this morning's heavy rain.
Aleix Espargaro's eyes will light up as well to that. Here he comes, though. He's having a look up the inside into MG. And they're now going three abreast as Miller forces his way past Luca Marini. He's already got past Alex Marquez on this lap. He now takes Marini. So Miller now in a very good position to help his teammate Bagnaia. He's up behind Quartararo.
He made that fit quite brilliantly, didn't he, there? Jack Miller, there was not a lot of room there, but he hooked the inside line and squeezed on the inside of Marini. Nothing the Italian could do about that one then. Lap two about to be completed here in Australia. Your race leader is still Jorge Martin from pole position.